Okay, so welcome to the session on the Cloud Starter Toolkit version 2. So for the next 15 minutes or so, I'm going to take you through how you can create contextual help with the toolkit. Before we get started, I'll just ask you to read through the disclaimer. Okay, so today, the main focus of the session is one of the new features of version 2 of the toolkit, which is adding contextual help to an application. So I'm basically going to take you through how you can add that help capability, how it works, so that you can add that to your own applications. So following on from the last session around version 2 of the toolkit, we released version 2 quite recently. It has a number of new features, but just as a recap, these are the kind of capabilities that the Cloud Starter Toolkit gives you. Effectively, the toolkit is there to make it easy for you to quickly create applications on TIBCO Cloud, and it contains a number of components such as documentation, Angular UI code building blocks, deployment utilities, CI/CD pipelines, libraries, and template applications. The idea really being we're trying to accelerate your ability to create applications on TIBCO Cloud. Okay, so as I said, the focus today is on the contextual help feature that we added in version 2. The intention is very much that once you've got an application, you can make that much easier for your users to use the application by adding a contextual help bar purely through configuration of the application, much like the one you can see on the left-hand side of the screen. So as I said, this is a new feature in Cloud Starter's version 2. And the idea is that the help that you will display on your screens will be very much contextual to what your user is actually doing. So there's two main ways that that works. You can provide help specific to the application page that they're working on in kind of Angular terms, which the UI is built in, that's a route. So if I'm on a cases page, I'd give you information about the cases. If I'm on a document page, I give you information about document operations. And you can also make that help even more contextual by actually programmatically setting the help context. So rather than just displaying help for, say, the case page, if you then clicked an activity that brought up a dialogue, you can actually provide a specific help on that thing that the user is doing at that point. There's three main things that the help can provide your users with. There's the ability to embed video links. You can have external links to external documentation pages or reference documents, and you can also provide inline help within kind of expandable elements. So I'm just going to switch over to the app and show you what this help can look like so you get an idea. Okay, so you should be able to see my case manager application and I'm on the case page. If I go and hit the help icon at the top of the nav bar at the top of the screen, you basically see the help bar come in from the right hand side. And as you can see, there's a video player, which I can go ahead and play. And there's actually two videos here attached. And then I've got what we call an inline help. What are these capabilities about that I can drill into? The next one is actually an external link. So if I click on that, it'll open a new page in a new tab. And then at the bottom, there's some references. So I think one of them is a PDF document on legal notices. So I could click on that and open that one. And the other one's a link to our community page. So that's the kind of help capabilities that we have for you to create. The idea being that each of these sections in the middle would be kind of the bulk of the help, which would give you all the information about all the things you can do on that application page. And then the video for somebody that just wants kind of a walkthrough of what this particular part of the application does. Obviously, you can choose which bits of the help you want and so forth. You can also expand the help if you need to, if you're going to have a lot of information on that screen. Okay, so back to the PowerPoint. How do you enable contextual help? So first of all, the contextual help can be enabled by just setting this attribute integrated help on the navbar component that's provided with all the applications from the Cloud Starter Toolkit. It's typically in the starter app route, in the HTML template for the starter app. So I'm just going to switch over and show you what that looks like. But you can kind of see it in the screenshot where we've got this TC TIBCO Cloud nav bar. And then there's a flag that we've set integrated help to turn that on. So just to show you what that looks like, here's my application code. And if I go into my routes within my source app and then go into starter app onto the template, and this tag here, that's basically the nav bar, the blue bar at the top of the application that you saw previously. And you'll see within here, I've just set this flag integrated help to be true. And that's enough to turn the integrated help feature on. So how does the application know which help file to look at and what to show? Okay, so by default, when you just turn it on, the help functionality is going to look for a configuration file, config.json, and it's going to look in the path that matches the root of your page in the source assets help. So if I go back over to the code, if you see within your application, you should have an assets folder. And basically there's a help folder within there, and then you can create basically a folder structure that matches your root with a config.json in it. If I just jump back to the application, you can see in the URL, your root is effectively this starter app case part. So that's basically without the parameters afterwards, that is the application root that you're currently looking at. If you go to a different page in your application, it would be a different root and would therefore look in a different place for your help files. Once we've got the right location, we basically read this config.json, and that's going to tell the help bar what to show. So let's drill a little bit more into how that works. As you can see, the config.json basically has three main sections, and they map to the three main parts of the help bar. There's a section for video, which is typically at the top. There's a section for inline help, and there's a section for external references. I'm just going to go to the next slide so you can kind of see the details of how they work. So let's start with the video. So you'll see that the video section of the file, this top section, is literally just an array of links to the video files that you want to put within your application. So here you can see I've got a video which links to assets help videos discover.mp4, and that's the first video that will appear. Within the file itself, you'll be able to see here that there's I've actually got two videos, so you can have as many videos as you want to include in there. The external references are, there's basically two places you can have those. You can set up a link at the bottom of the help bar, as I did for the community and the PDF document that opened, and you can see that you basically add these keys just to give it a name, TIBCO community. Additional text is the text underneath, and then the link that it will go to with an icon. If we go over to the help bar, that's these ones at the bottom that you can see. So it's just giving the information that you can see there, and it will display those at the bottom of the help bar. In the file, that's these two here. But there's one other place that you can also use external links, and that's within the main section of the toolbar. So here you can see within this middle section, I've got an external link for my partner app, and that can actually be a link to your external documentation site if you have one, or reference information. It works much the same way. It's just got a slightly different syntax. So the other main option for help is the idea of an inline help. So here you can see I've got a section, what are these capabilities about? And basically what I have here is kind of like a drill down. So if I click on that section, the help bar is going to open up and I can see a bunch of textual information that gives me contextual help on that particular topic. The way that works is that within the config file, you basically link to a URL to a HTML. And it's just simple markup that you can then add that will appear within that section of the UI. So to show you what that looks like, if you can just see the middle section under inline, just here. So you can see that I've got type inline, and then I've got the text, what are these capabilities about? And then I've got a link to a HTML file. The HTML file is just simple markup, basically, that will display within the user interface. You can just write, as you can see at the bottom of the screen there, you can just write your simple markup as you wish to. And then within the UI, the way that will work is that when you click on that link, it'll open up and you'll basically see that markup within the context of the bit that you expanded. So that's the main functionality of the help bar. So there's videos, inline links, external links, and the references at the bottom. But there's one more thing that you can do with the help capability, and that is to actually set your context programmatically. So as I said before, the default behavior is that the route context is set based on which page you're on, just using that URL for the route. However, there's some scenarios when you might want to change the help context based on what the user is doing in your application. A typical scenario there would be, for example, in a dialogue box that comes up, say, with a wizard, as you can see on this slide. So what we can do there is use part of the toolkit called the message topic service, and you can send a message to the integrated help component to tell it to change the context of the help file. You can do that from your code whenever you like by injecting the message topic service. And then basically as your user clicks on icons on the application, you can change the context to display a different help file based on what they're actually doing at that point within that screen. So it just gives you a way of providing even more contextual help for an operation in your application. Once they've come out of that wizard, you would typically then set the context back to the page route. And of course, if you change pages in the application, the context will change automatically. So to summarize the session, this is the Cloud Starters Toolkit version 2, and we basically added a capability to make it easy for you to add contextual help to your cloud applications. You can add videos, inline help, and external links, and you can make that help either contextual to the page or route that your application's on, or you can programmatically set it via the message topic service. So next time, we're gonna look in a bit more detail at the CI/CD support. So that's the ability to kind of manage your cloud applications using a build pipeline, like for example, Jenkins, and using the command line interface that we provide as part of the Cloud Starters toolkit. Just a few things before we finish. I just point you at the TIBCO Cloud website. If you want to get up and running and start creating some applications, you can go and get a free TIBCO Cloud trial to get you started on the service by following the link on the screen. And then if you want to actually create some Cloud Starter Toolkit applications, you can jump in and go to the labs page and look up the information about the Cloud Starters Toolkit to get started. And finally, I just want to point you at the other TIBCO Labs references, where you can go and join our community or find out more information about meetups with TIBCO Labs. And that finishes the session today on contextual help.